Hi there, Matt Wade here, and today we're going to try to wrap our brains around one of the most difficult aspects of Microsoft 365 and Office 365, and that is how to keep up with the constant changes in the ecosystem. It's admittedly not easy, but there are some tips you can use starting today that will make things a bit easier whether you're an administrator or an everyday user. So let's dive right in. The Microsoft Cloud brings with it many, many benefits. Minimal concern for storage space, no disruptive migrations or upgrades, and regular improvements and updates to your apps. You're always running the most up-to-date version of whatever app you're running. However, with those benefits comes some head-spinning, hyper-speed of updates, changes, new apps, and even features you depended on being sent to their graves early, sometimes feeling like the rug is just being pulled out from under you. There's no perfect way to track these things. Microsoft stays tight-lipped about a lot of the features and updates until the last moment, but there are ways to keep as well-informed as you possibly can. This video covers big-picture ways to track these changes, and this list is just one man's opinion. I'd love to hear what you do to try to stay sane in this ever-changing world by leaving a comment below. On a related note, I put together an infographic and a spreadsheet that covers app-specific resources, including blogs, roadmaps, Twitter handles, community forums, and other feedback avenues. So definitely check that out if you want a way to follow apps or services in a more granular way. So let's get into it. First, the biggest resource you'll see referenced is the Microsoft 365 Admin Message Center. This is a good centralized listing of upcoming changes to your system. It's also a good source for system outages when something like Teams or SharePoint goes down. But I hate even referencing it first because it's the biggest downside it has is you have to have at least some sort of administrator role to access the Message Center. There is no public version of the Message Center, as much as I wish there was. Two things I really like about it are the mobile app, so you can get push notifications on updates and outages, and the weekly digest email that you can automatically receive. For the email digest, you can even include other people, two additional email addresses per admin, I think, so you can sort of just barely get around the fact that the Message Center is not actually available to non-admins. Second, if you want to test new features first, get set up as a targeted release user. People on targeted release get early access to a lot of features, though not everything goes through targeted release first. So as an example, we were able to play with Teams Together Mode and Microsoft Lists early this summer, weeks, even months ahead of regular users. The point of targeted release is to give a small group of users early access and the ability to test the new features outside of Microsoft. And once Microsoft sees things are going well, these features roll out to everyone. An admin can make any person in the organization a targeted release user, so if you're not an admin and you want early access, reach out to your IT team and ask them. If you have a good justification, there's really little reason for them to say no, as long as you agree to not bombard them with trouble tickets surrounding, you know, unsupported features or new things they're not ready for yet. Third, follow Microsoft 365 status on Twitter. This is an official Microsoft account and it tweets whenever there's a system outage on one of Microsoft 365's services. Frankly, I find this source to be faster and more reliable than the Admin Message Center, and unlike the Message Center, it's publicly available. It's one of the few Twitter push notifications I have enabled, and I also have this set up to post a tweet directly into a dedicated Teams channel so that my team can be updated whenever something like this happens. You can find a link to the Power Automate workflow that makes that possible in the video description. Fourth, keep an eye on the Microsoft 365 roadmap. Many of the upcoming tools and features are listed there. You can filter based on app, search, and link back to specific items. Each item has its own item number that you can reference. Note that many features never make it to the roadmap. Teams Together Mode, for example, was a surprise when it was announced and launched. It never saw the roadmap. Roadmap dates are also known to change. So just because it says something is due in quarter one of 2021 doesn't mean it will be delivered then. Fifth, one of the best ways to track upcoming features is through UserVoice. UserVoice is a community forum type tool that Microsoft contracts with to track requested features. People vote for features, and high-voted entries generally get worked and come with status updates. This can act as a back doorway to get a more realistic timeline on delivery on a requested feature that's also on the roadmap. The dates may not always line up, and I find UserVoice to be more trustworthy because you're hearing directly from the engineers working on the feature. Be aware that even if something is popular, you may not see that feature rolled into the app that you're requesting. Sixth, attend events. The Microsoft 365 community is noted for being one of the best communities in tech. Having now attended and spoken at dozens of them, I can attest to that personally. Sessions you attend at these events will provide a ton of real-world case studies, examples, lessons learned, and best practices, usually without the gimmicky and markety fluff that would normally come from Microsoft itself. The biggest feature announcements will always be at Microsoft Ignite in the fall, Inspire in the spring, Microsoft 365 Collaborations Conference in the spring, Microsoft Build in late spring, and Microsoft Inspire in early summer. But you'll see plenty of announcements at other events, especially ones where Jeff Teper is speaking. Being the corporate vice president at Microsoft, overseeing most of Microsoft 365, he's known for announcing new features year-round, even at small user group events. On top of all this, the recent switch from most industry events going from in-person to online is actually quite a boon to people who can't afford to travel or attend learning events in person because almost all of these events have moved online and cost nothing to attend. And a lot of the sessions at these events are just as relevant for everyday users as they are for IT professionals. So the switch to online is even more impactful because that population is much larger and is less likely to justify the expense of an in-person conference. I try to keep a list of upcoming events on our blog, so there's a link in the description to that. It's not an easy task to manage this list, so if you notice something is missing, please let me know and we will update that as soon as we can. Seventh, become a member of the Microsoft Tech Community. This is where a lot of the Microsoft product teams publish update blogs. It's also a forum for discussion, including technical support, best practices, and getting guidance on how to implement a solution within given apps. Each app pretty much has its own dedicated space in the tech community. The exception is the Power Platform apps, which have their own forums linked in the video description below. Eighth, follow the Microsoft 365 YouTube channel to watch the What's New with Microsoft 365 monthly video series. This is usually a 7 to 15 minute retrospective published at the end of each month. It's quick, easily digestible, and has recently seen a notable upgrade in production value. Unfortunately, they don't provide a playlist of all the historical episodes. I have no idea why. So you'll just have to keep an eye out when the channel posts or scroll through their past videos to take a look at those. Ninth, the community has a ton of content out there. So I'm gonna give a few really quick shout outs here that you should really make sure to follow. Links are in the description. First, follow Regarding 365 on YouTube to get notified when Daniel Glenn and Daryl Webster post their weekly 365 Message Center show. Check out Patrick Finninger's Microsoft Roadmap Roundup for a short, concise, weekly overview of updates on the M365 roadmap. And even if you hate Twitter, it's actually one of the best places to follow updates and discussion around feature and app updates. I've created some Twitter lists of Microsoft accounts that I find provide really useful content, not just marketing stuff. You can use your Twitter account to follow these lists. As you spend a little time on Twitter, pay attention to the people taking part in the conversation. Those community members are great for providing no BS insights into many of the changes and updates. Follow Chris Hoard on Twitter and Chris Webb in the tech community for updates about Microsoft Teams and Office 365 in general. I'm not sure how these guys have time to even sleep on a given day. They're so active online and within the community. Follow Tony Redmond for updates on Outlook and Exchange especially, and Microsoft Teams. His updates are more on the admin side of things. Follow Gregory Zelvand, also known as the SharePoint Maven, for updates and guides on everyday SharePoint and Teams features. And follow Mark Anderson for SharePoint Power User, Content Management, and Development features. Now, there are thousands of people and organizations out there that put out great content about M365. The few I mentioned before are especially good at covering the implications of these changes. I also didn't mention anything about the hundreds of really helpful Facebook groups, LinkedIn groups, subreddits, and even user groups in Microsoft Teams hosted by organizations like Collab 365. Nor did I bring up partner companies like AvePoint, Valo, ShareGate, and the like that put out such great content on updates and use cases within M365. While this all likely sounds overwhelming, take a taste from each of the courses I've served today and decide which ones work for you. Some people hate Twitter enough they'll never set foot there again. And some people love the Microsoft tech community. So in those instances, your options are a bit clearer. Once again, this is just one man's opinion, and I'm really curious to know what resources you follow to keep up to date with the craziness in the cloud world. Leave a comment below so others can benefit, and as always, a like and a subscribe is always appreciated. So thanks so much for watching, and best of luck making the most of these resources and more when staying in the know with Microsoft 365 and Office 365.